Okay, so I know I just recently uploaded a SiteGround video on this and a HostGator video on this, but this video is for Bluehost people, right? So if you're using Bluehost, I'll be showing you how to create a professional email in Bluehost and to connect it with Gmail. So you can basically manage all your emails in your Gmail inbox, for example, even sending it out as your professional domain email, okay? And then also receiving email. So everything is in one place and everything's super easy for you, right? It's also good for branding purposes, and you also need it if you're creating a WooCommerce e-commerce store to prevent like warning messages that you send out to customer order confirmations. Okay, so what you wanna do is just go to bluehost.com, right? And then you can click on the top right here to log into your account. All right, so click on the hosting login tab. And here, just enter in your domain name or your email. And I'm gonna select this and click on login. All right, so select your domain name. Okay, so once you're here, instead of clicking over here, what you wanna do is you wanna log into your cPanel area. So click on the cPanel. All right, so once in your cPanel, you wanna scroll down and you wanna try and look for email accounts. All right, so click on email accounts. And over here, we wanna create a new email account on our domain name. So click on create. All right, so here, this is your username. So for example, hello@bluedemo123.com, or it might be like info. So let's just say help. All right, @bluedemo123.com. Your one will be your domain. And here you wanna set in your password. All right, so just set in a strong password that you can remember. And here you can set in your storage space. So I normally just go for like 1000 megabytes. You can select unlimited if you have more space on your hosting account. All right, then after that, then we're just gonna click on create. All right, so once that is created, then that email has been created here. So we're gonna connect it with Gmail, and what you need to do is go and log into your Gmail account. Just hover over here, click on it, and then click on settings. All right, so click on the accounts and import tab. So scroll down to check email from other accounts. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna log in using this, right? So click on add an email account, okay? Drag that in, and we're gonna copy over the email. All right, just copy that to your clipboard. And then sometimes that goes on the back here. So just minimize your screen, paste that in here, and click on next. Next again. So for your username, it's exactly the same as your email address. And for your password, it is the password that you just set in. Now for your POP server, this is gonna be just your domain name. So yourdomain.com, right? And for the port, you wanna select 995. And here, always use a secure connection, SSL. And you can also label incoming messages as well. All right, just like that. And then click on add account. All right, so that has been added and it's gonna be able to log into your email account and retrieve the email so you can populate onto your Gmail inbox. Right, so what it's asking you now is, do you wanna be able to send email as help@bluedemo123.com. So we're gonna click on next, and here you can set in a name, right? And then I'm just gonna click on next step. And then for the SMTP server, this is just your domain.com, right? So your domain.com, and select the port here to be 465. Username is your email address, all right? Password is the same one. And then make sure it's set to secure connection, SSL, add account. Okay, so once that has been done, then they'll need you to confirm that you own that email. So they'll send you an email to confirm that, right? So let's just go back over here. Okay, so over here, check email from other accounts. As you can see, it has been added. So what we wanna do is you can click on check mail now, and that's gonna pull in that email from this email address. And as you can see, one email has been fetched, right? So we can just go to the inbox and then we can click over here and then we can click on the link. Okay, so just click on the link here and then we need to click on confirm. And then that's pretty much it. All right. So we can go back to, and so we can refresh the page first. And then what you want to do is click on compose. All right. And then you can click on the drop down, and then you can select the email that you want to display when you're emailing someone else. All right. So you can also set it as a default. So click on the settings tab here. And then what you want to do is click on accounts and import. All right. So for the send mail as, you can make it as a default. So for example, if you want it to always be sending as this email, you can click on make default. All right. So that is pretty much it. Except I want to quickly show you, if you have an e-commerce store using WooCommerce and WordPress, you want to make sure that you set in a professional email in your settings area. So click on WooCommerce and click on the settings tab. All right. And then click on the emails tab. And then after that, scroll down. Okay. For the email sender options, you want to always send it from a domain email. You want it to be the same domain as the one that you're using. All right. Because otherwise it's going to give a warning message, and that's not going to be good for your customers to see, because they might think your website's like not legitimate. All right. So that's really, really important. If you have any questions, drop it down in the comment section below. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more videos. Thanks.